Hey everybody, thanks for watching. This is the long-awaited vlog. Match play, four holes of match play. Bobby Lopez, PGA versus myself from Pendleton Golf Club, a gorgeous golf course about 30 minutes north of Richmond, Virginia. Come check it out. Hey guys, I'm out on the golf course with Bobby Lopez here at Pendleton Golf Club, is that right?
Right, Pendleton Golf Club.
Pendleton Golf Club.
Right on 595.
In just about half an hour north of Richmond. Beautiful golf course. They say it's like going to Scotland without the airfare, so come check it out. We're gonna do a little match today. It'll either be three holes or four holes, whatever we get in. Bobby versus me, match play. Here's the first hole. It is a dogleg to the left, par five. Dogleg really doesn't come into it after the first shot. And Bobby's on the tee. Bobby used to be a touring pro in the on the European tour in the 70s, and now is a
gorgeous
teacher.
Shot, Bobby.
Bobby went right down the middle there. Here you go. Hand that off to you.
Just aim it between the two small bunkers.
Yeah, just follow me.
All right.
You can go maybe a little bit left of that and take a little more of a shortcut, but.
Okay, so here's my tee shot. I'm just getting off of the range with Bobby at this point after we did a bunch of Be Better Golf videos. And there I'm doing Tony Lutzak's drill, the flamingo drill, and Bobby really liked that.
Beauty, good swing.
That was a good one.
If I can ask a personal question.
Go ahead.
What was the biggest tournament success that you had as far as check cashed or cut made or something like that?
It was Sweden, probably 1974, but you got to remember, back in the 70s, especially in the European tour, I mean, first prize was like,
yeah,
nothing.
You know, yeah.
There was no real money in it. Like Jose Maria Cañizares said when he came over here and played in the senior tour, he made more money in 1 year on the senior tour here than he made in 20 years on the European tour.
Right, right.
Now the European tour has more money in it from what I hear, but
yeah.
It wasn't back then.
Yeah, back then I remember you would, well, I wasn't alive, but I heard about guys saying that a lot of good, some good golfers would stay amateur because they would make more money gambling.
Yeah.
Than they would if everybody knew that they were a pro.
But we gambled on the practice rounds all the time.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It didn't stop us, yeah, right. But for golfers that are watching this and they feel like they do well on the range, they even do well playing with their friends, but then in a tournament, they start to really get tight and get nervous. What do you tell people that feel like they just can't perform?
You've got to have something that you're attempting to do. Like I said when we were on the range, and I said, don't try and fix the bad shots, just keep trying to do what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to say the same thing to my kid when he was a place kicker.
Yeah.
I say, you know, don't try and kick it between the two poles. You know, believe in your practice, believe in what you did, and just say, hey, it's all going to work out when I get there. So the same thing here, you have a swing key at the most.
Yeah.
Two, but
yeah.
Maybe just one.
Mm-hmm.
And say, this is what I'm trying to do, and I'm going to keep doing it come heck or high water.
Yeah.
And believe in that. And every bad shot you have, just erase it from your memory bank out. You got to be like a defensive back, no memory.
Yep. So this is a par five we're on. And just laying up here, Bobby?
Oh yeah, we won't reach the green, at least I won't, you might.
No, probably not.
See, now this is not very nice of you to hit the ball that far past me. What is that, 30 yards?
Well.
At least.
I'm exactly 30 years younger than you, so.
Oh. You got a good swing too.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you another thing, I tell a lot of these kids who are doing kids lessons, play other sports too. It's a big advantage that you played baseball and did karate.
Yeah.
I like wrestling.
Yeah.
You know?
I wrestled for a little bit too.
Yeah, wrestling is good for kids. All right, I'm going to hit it. You got two linebackers there. Right? You see the two bunkers way down there. I call them linebackers.
Yep.
So I'm going to go a little left of them.
All right.
And try and leave it about maybe 70 yards short of the green.
Woo! That is good, Bobby. That is fun to watch, right there. Okay, so quick replay of Bobby's swing, very wide going back, and he stays back on it and extends through, really great swing. That is fun to watch. All right, Bobby, if you were my caddy and we were playing the US Mid Amateur, what would you tell me here?
Well, first, let's find out what the yardage is.
Exactly.
46,
45, 44,
45. 235. The problem is there's a lot of danger right of the green and left of the green.
Oh, forget it. Yeah. So
I would hit whatever you hit the straightest, whether it's a hybrid or whether it's a 5-wood.
Okay, yeah.
I leave it short of the green, by maybe 30 yards short of the green.
Cool. All right, we might have missed that one. I'm not sure. I hit it a little right of what I wanted, but solid. And I felt like I wasn't, you know, digging deep on it. Felt nicely swept.
No, you swept it right off the ground.
Yeah, this actually is really pretty. A pretty golf course. It's funny, playing in California, if you miss the fairway,
yeah,
you're in another fairway. In playing here, if you miss the fairway, you will not find your ball.
You can go looking for it, but you might get bit by a snake.
Yeah.
All right, now you notice, if you turn around this way and look at all the humps.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Look over here, you see how it's flat?
Yeah.
That's the designer saying to you, hey, if you play short and play safe, I'm going to mess you up because I'm going to give you a bunch of humps. I'm going to give you a bunch of side hill lies.
Yeah.
If you go past my two linebackers here, I'm going to reward you with a nice flat ground. I always set the club face first when I get shots like this, because now club face is the boss. Get up.
You're pretty good, Bobby. Okay, so Bobby is in that low spot. I'm here with about 40 yards.
If that.
If that, yeah, maybe to the stick. I'm gonna have, now I usually, Bobby, tell me what you think of this. It's like a shot like this, I'll play like a half and half shot, like half carry, half roll. Or what do you think?
Yeah, I use as much roll as I can, but there's a lot of hump right there. Make sure you start it right of the hole because it's gonna go left. Okay. Good job. Get up there. Get up there. Get up there.
I'm with you. Yeah, it was a little duffy going through that one.
It's all right.
When I vlog, I have a local rule that it's okay to leave the stick in so people can see where the hole is.
Okay. So I always look at the line from the back.
Yeah.
But I can see it so much better than from the front. This ball's got to go left.
All right, Bobby for birdie. Ran it on a little bit.
I was worried about getting it up the hill. Once it got up the hill, it went. There you go.
All right, here's my putt for birdie. I had the benefit of seeing Bobby go from a real similar line to mine, so I knew I had to hit it.
Good putt.
I'll finish.
That's good.
These are the ones that bust your chops.
Absolutely. Okay, Bobby Lopez for par to tie me on the first hole.
All right, even got a fist pump out of him. Little different when it's gonna be
on video forever and ever. Hey, what do you think about when you have those must make putts? More thinking about line on the closer ones and speed on the further ones, or?
No, I'm thinking club face control. Club face control. The ball's going to go where the club face is.
Right.
So I make sure that I've set that putter face exactly where I want that ball to go.
Yeah.
And then I make as short and as compact and firm a stroke that I can, where I move the club head as little as possible. Shorter strokes is better on the shorter putts.
Yeah, because less can go wrong.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, you got less chance of moving that club face, because if you change the club face angle during the stroke.
After we film this couple holes that we're going to play, I'll be really interested to do a what's in the bag with Bobby, because he has an interesting set here, including a putter that looks older than I am.
It is.
Yeah.
Putter and the puttee are both older than
you. Yeah, right. All right, moving on to the second hole, freeze frame here, 419 yards from where we are. This is a par four, and let's pan back just a little bit to see. It's a little bit of a dogleg right, but it doesn't really affect your tee shot.
If we had our way, we could pick that green up and move it back some and make that first hole a long par four.
Yeah.
And then make this a par five, move the tee back some. It would
be it's more set up for it.
Oh, yeah, because the green is small, and you're going to be hitting a hybrid or a four or five iron into it.
Yeah. So your line is, like, over where the cart is on the right?
Yeah, you see that guy with the red shirt right now? Uh-huh. Hit him right in the head.
Okay, okay. All square going in the second hole. Bobby's here. Not an easy hole, huh, Bobby?
No. This is a tough hole. It's a tough hole. Anything left of the bunker tree.
Beautiful, Bobby. Real pretty fade, about mid-high. Really nice. How far do you think you'll have in there?
At least a hybrid. Okay. I bet you I'm 190 out. And now on the tee, winner of the Conchita Invitational from Guadalajara, Mexico, Señor Brendan Hernandez. Wow, that's not fair.
No, that was a good one.
That's not fair.
That was a good,
good
one.
Shot.
Thank you.
Look at that.
Now,
killer.
Usually after, like I just did 5 minutes ago, usually after you have a golf lesson, you can't play golf at all. Usually a golf lesson will screw you up on the course.
They get too complicated.
The thing about Bobby and lessons with him, I think that's maybe the reason for quick fix golf. Now, when you say quick fix golf, it's kind of almost like a negative connotations for some people.
I know,
you know, like
I've
a
heard,
quick fix.
I've thought of that a million times.
Yeah.
And what happened was a buddy of mine made this website called Quick Fix Golf.
Yeah.
And he asked me to help him out.
Uh-huh.
And then he left town and he said, hey, do you want to buy it? And he sold it to me. And I sort of just, the original idea was it was going to have all these tips. And you could go on there and you say, hey, I'm
what's
shanking.
What's my problem?
Quick
yeah.
fix me.
Yeah.
And you press a button and you got a quick fix tip.
Yeah.
A quick fix for your problem. But we're not really a quick fix, except that we're very quick to be able to determine what it is, the problem that you have.
Yeah.
With the video, I can point out right away, well, here's what's going on.
And it doesn't, taking a golf lesson or getting golf instruction doesn't have to be like this exercise in humility and, like, you know, break you down and everything. It can sometimes be fun and easy.
Listen, yeah. Especially when I'm dealing with seniors and old guys, I said, you won't live long enough to make that swing change.
Right.
You'll be dead by the time you figure out that.
So let's just get you able to get around the course a little bit. Yeah.
Yes. I got it.
What club do you want?
The hybrid. I always would rather throttle back on a shot than.
Yeah. All right, the flag stick is right about there. Oh, that's so pretty looking, Bobby. That looks really good.
Thank you. I'm having an autograph session this afternoon.
All right. A little above my feet.
Knock it up there close. Hold it. You're lined up way right.
Yeah, it's above my feet, so.
Okay, so you're gonna play that much of a spin. Okay.
Maybe not. Probably. I was probably lined more. I mean, see where your ball is, Bobby?
Right.
That's kind of where I want to be lined up.
Okay.
So I was probably too far. How's that?
Let her rip. Good one.
Wow, that was good.
Good shot.
Awesome. Thank you. Yeah, right now, all I'm thinking, I'm at the top, and I'm just going to switch places.
Yeah, there
you know?
Go.
There's no drive to the left or you know, lag or loop
just
it or anything.
Sure, like you're on, what was his name? The other guy that was got you doing a one-foot drill?
Yeah, Tony.
Tony, yeah. Doing the same thing. So he's just taking his right arm. Just get rid of the golf club. Once you get it to the top, you're set where you want to be. You just get rid of it.
So you have a shot that's downhill, and then once it's on the green, it's going downhill even more.
Yeah, I'm looking at trying to land this ball right about here.
Okay.
Stick than I thought I would use. I'm going to use the 52 instead of the 48.
because I think this puppy's gonna move. This ground's a little wet here. Oh, that would have been enough to piss you off.
That's good. Good par. Good one.
Chip it and land it here.
You can make this.
That's a really good swing thought, huh?
Yeah.
Instead of just like trying to get it closer, hit a good shot, try to hole it.
Yeah. Why not? Everybody else does it.
Okay, so I'm going to try to hold this one. It's sitting well. And actually, that fringe has really grown up, so I can't putt it like I normally would. So I'm going to try to make up.
There you go. Good shot. That's good.
This is something you really don't see anywhere in California. These really cool wood bridges in thick, thick woods. I grew up in Pennsylvania. We used to have woods like this there, and which makes you think of like the American Revolution and Civil War and stuff like that going on in woods like this. So it's really cool to see the different, it's great to be in America and have, you know, the desert and the Los Angeles area where I live, and then, I mean, all in one country. It's pretty awesome. Really gorgeous course here.
All right, please excuse my slightly excessive patriotism there. We were trying to find an open hole and came across
Beautiful.
These guys.
Look at that, right down the
middle. First guy hit an awesome shot right down the middle. Then the second guy sliced it.
Oh, to the right.
It opens up out there.
Then turn on it. That's what I get for getting orders. I hit all the fairways.
You do this on the way back. You roll it open. Take it this way.
Okay. I've been
hitting all the fairway. That's the first one I missed. All right, Bobby. So we just, driving through here, we saw a guy hit a wicked slice. That's got to be the number one search thing on YouTube, how to stop slicing the golf ball. So with him in particular, because we can see the replay, and with golfers in general, what do you usually give as like a slice prescription?
Tell you what, let's do this right over here.
Okay. We're zipping through the golf course and trying to find an open hole. And we saw a guy hit a monster slice, and Bobby's gonna get into it a little bit.
If you understand the golf club and how it's designed, then you'll understand why you slice. The club is designed to slice.
Oh, really?
This is a tennis racket. So the shaft is in the center, and the tennis racket goes around like this.
Mm-hmm.
Just like our body. The head's in the center, the vertebrae's in the center. What if your vertebrae was down your left arm? You'd walk like this, right? You'd go in a circle. The golf club, if you had it this way with the shaft on top, is so good that it's illegal.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Arnold Palmer, rest his soul, he came up with these clubs called the Peerless, the Palmer Peerless, and it had a little triangle that came out on the other side. He was trying to do that. He was trying to offset the weight on the other side of the axis, and they kicked it out. USGA wouldn't allow it. So what they did allow was this little teeny thing that really didn't have much of an influence at all. But that's the problem with the golf club. So then the further the face is away from the axis, the harder it is. Imagine a tennis racket with the shaft on the bottom and the tennis racket part on the top. You'd have a heck of a time putting any topspin on the ball. So you get these big drivers, 460cc. They're even harder to square up than a hybrid. First they sell you a hybrid, and they say, you gotta have one of these hybrids. It's got a little tiny head on it. And you say, man, I'm getting this hybrid really great. Say, yeah, now we're gonna give you a driver. Now we're gonna give you a basketball on the end of the stick. Why? They'd be better off, most of them, with a smaller head. That's why so many of the pros use the 395 head. They don't use the big 460 head.
Yeah.
Because then the further you get away from the axis, the harder it is to square the club up. And this guy, his first move was to open the face on the way back. So he's toast.
So to counteract that twisting that it wants to do, what do you put into it? You just have to make sure it's absolutely square.
Yeah, you've got to realize that impact is slightly closed, maybe 3 degrees closed. You've got to make an effort to get this club to come over. You've got to rotate the club around the axis.
Yeah, if you're hitting it with this kind of chopping, karate
right,
chop, forget it.
Yeah.
So that is Bobby's slice fix. So we had to find an open hole, so we went to the eighth hole all the way through. And this hole is interesting. It's a dogleg right. Lots of undulations that don't show up on the Google Maps. And right there is a graveyard that this hole is famous for. So you want to aim just to the right of that clump that you can see out there. And that was maybe a little too far right.
I might get lucky from up here though. All right, that little clump.
Yeah, you go right over it, just right of it.
So I'm aiming just a little right of it. I'm doing my Tony Lutzak drill. I'm gonna be traveling to Mississippi next week to meet with Tony, and he'll include himself in this power package video series that we're doing.
Oh man, you're swinging nice. That is roasted. Sell the furniture and go on the road.
Yeah, right.
This is the remains of an old farmhouse, and there is a tree that with a bunch of old gravestones here.
Yeah, you don't want to walk through that area right there because a hand might come out of the ground and grab your ankle. Oh, yeah, I thought it was funny.
I'm looking for my rangefinder.
It's 80 yards.
How's that for lineup, Bobby?
There you go.
After walking out, it was actually 87 yards after shooting this, but I got it. I was really concentrated on my tempo. Made an okay tempo, but you know, way too hard, a little right.
Wow.
Too far.
Bobby cut this corner a little bit. Really nice, Bobby. Right on it. And coming back a little bit. Really nice. Hey, Bobby, what did I do wrong there in my wedge shot? I felt like I did something wrong. I couldn't put my finger on it. Felt a little disconnected from my feel.
Yeah, you just looked like you came under here,
yes,
a little bit.
Yeah, okay. Right. Yeah, make one bad swing, you don't have to change the whole world.
Just no, right. I was just saying, ignore it. Keep trying to do what you're trying to do.
Yeah.
Keep doing what you're trying to do.
I guess you would call that a green in regulation what I have, but that is actually that's another thing I'm good at. I am a good lag putter, but this is gonna test me for sure.
This is gonna be a beauty. You might not be able to see it with the video, but there's a big hump. You know, my mother-in-law is buried under there.
She was big, huh?
Good putt. Good putt. Good putt.
It's been raining a ton in this area, so the greens are a little slower than normal, I think.
Your putting strokes are real good.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. And I like the cross-handed. That's fine.
You know, I learned that way. My brother does cross-handed, and he taught me, and it's the only way I've ever putted, actually. All right, to tie the hole.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
That's good.
Made it anyway. I don't know how legal it is to putt with the iPhone in the hand, but I'm pretty good at it.
That's unbelievable.
You were so relaxed when you rolled it that way.
Yeah, very relaxed.
Relaxed, exactly.
There's absolutely no consequences because you have an excuse. You say, I wasn't really trying.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's just like throwing a piece of paper in a wastebasket. The first time you just take and throw it goes in. Then if somebody says, hey, I'll give you $20 if you can make it again, now you start thinking. You know,
right. Thanks for watching all this content from Virginia with Bobby and I. We have plans for the future to do more stuff together. Did you have fun today with the Be Better Golf, Bobby?
This is a fabulous thing you're doing. And it's great because it's independent from all the big wheels that run the industry.
Right.
You're able to do what you want. Yeah. I think it's great. Well, we can still play number 9 if you want.
Yeah, let's play, because there's nobody here.
Yeah.
Bonus content. Par 5, Bobby? Again?
No,
actually.
Par 4, and it's a ball buster.
All right, the match is all square. We've made 3 pars each on the first 3 holes, and we're going to this sudden death playoff hole. You want to aim right there, down the middle.
You want to go left of that barber pole, please.
Really good, Bobby, right there.
Right even with that first bunker.
You got it.
I should have taken my Geritol this morning.
I saw that video where the coach almost took you out. The swing machine on YouTube.
Yeah.
And you were laughing at yourself.
Hey, if you can't laugh at yourself, what are you going to laugh?
I mean,
come on. You are the man.
That was a good one.
You are the man.
Oh, that was good.
You're my hero.
Thank you. This is quite the display of driving by me. If you guys have watched my vlogs, you know this is not normal. So hopefully it's the beginning of a trend.
I don't see why not. You got excellent coordination. You're yeah. like I'm an athlete.
Yeah.
I think you had so much stuff in your head that, you know, you can't read that book, The 45 Things to Think About at the Moment of Impact.
Right. Well, part of the amazing thing about having a Be Better Golf channel and part of the challenging thing is I interview a lot of golf pros and I get into a lot of different technical things. And that's the part of the golf game that I really enjoy and I'm really interested by. But sometimes in my own golf game, it can be kind of like a crowded restaurant, you know, lots of voices. So it's really good to kind of just
you got to realize some of the guys, some of the best players on tour, I'm telling you, are dumb as a bag of hammers. If they didn't play golf, you know, that's all they've done all their life. And,
yeah.
And, you know, you don't have to be a genius to play this game. You just have to use your natural athletic ability and common sense and swing within yourself. Don't try and kill it.
Yep.
And try and control the, if you can control the club face, you can control the ball.
Yep.
Period.
Let's see here. It looks like a blind shot here, Bobby.
Oh yeah, all these shots are blind.
A lot on this course, huh?
It's called Braille Country Club.
Yeah. So when you can't see anything, you're just picking out a tree trunk to go for.
You see that U in the trees right there? I'm going on the left side of the U.
Yeah, I see it. Beautiful, Bobby.
Don't be too much.
If you're thinking about the same you that I'm thinking about, that was really, really good.
Thank you.
How many yards should I hit this shot, do you think?
Good 150, 155.
Okay.
I saw something there. I want you to.
Shot turned out good, but what'd you say?
See, send me the video of this swing because that one, you got yourself shut at the top a little bit, bulged in the left wrist,
mm-hmm.
And sort of rerouted the golf club a little bit. So you must have let. Yeah, no, you yeah. When you got to the top, you must have done this.
Oh. Right.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Bobby.
Didn't have the right yardage, I don't think. Hit his hybrid well over the green. I'm just short of the green over there. Or I'm just on the green, on the short side of the green. Looking for your landing spot, Bobby?
That's what I'm looking to see, where I'm gonna land it, puppy. Ho, ho, ho. There you go. Put me out of my misery.
Thank you. Well, you've got a chance. That's good. Bobby, it was really fun.
It's all right, man.
All right, great.
Great par on the last hole. You did
yeah.
great.
Thank you, thank you. Yeah, I felt like I did what I wanted to do. Some old habits started leaking in, but I was, like you said, kind of when you're out here, you're just keep doing what you're trying to do, right? You have your swing key that you're working on and
right.
be consistent with it.
And whatever you do, do less, not more.
Okay.
Do less size backswing.
Yeah.
Slower tempo than you think.
Yeah.
When you get on the golf course, your tempo is going to go up and your golf swing is going to get bigger.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah,
it's easy to do it on the range.
Yeah.
Once you get out here, everything gets bigger.
So subscribe to Bobby's channel. It's in the link below. And check him out on Quick Fix Golf. As we've said, free analysis, your first one. Bobby on Quick Fix Golf, and any other ideas you guys have for content you'd like to see from us, we're going to try to link up in the future. I think it's going to be the beginning of a beautiful
And if you're going to come out here in this area and you happen to be out here, send me an email to BobbyLopez@quickfixgolf.com and I'll get you a discount to play over here at Pendleton.
Beautiful, beautiful course.
From Pendleton Golf Club, this is Be Better Golf, but stay tuned because there's an important announcement right now. Thanks for watching that. I filmed a lot of different stuff with Bobby in the time that I was there in Virginia, and going out on the course with him was a blast. I really recommend it if you guys get the chance. So while I was in Virginia, one of the big things that I did was I filmed a segment for this new Be Better Golf documentary called The Source of Power. And that's gonna be the name of it, Be Better Golf, The Source of Power. So it's all about how power is created in the swing. And what I do is I've been flying around the country. I went to Virginia, I'm here in California, I'm flying to Mississippi next week, and then I'm also flying to Arizona for a different project the week after that. So really putting a lot of work into the channel, a lot of investment as well. So coming up really soon, there'll be a pre-sale available for this Be Better Golf documentary, where you'll get some exclusive content before it even comes out. And so that's all really exciting. And then later I'll probably put an annotation on this video. So you might see it right here. It might already be available if you see the annotation come up right here. It's really exciting, and I'm really getting some great information from these coaches that are participating. And in this documentary, I really made sure that the coaches that are in it, while they may say things in different ways, they're really all on the same page about how power is really created. And they have different drills and different thought patterns about how to do it, but they're really on the same page about how most people can unlock their athletic ability and be a lot faster and a lot longer off the tee. So it's really exciting. So thanks a lot for watching this video. And also, the thing that I'm filming for another project is really exciting, that one of the top 100 coaches in the world, this guy named Mike Malaska, has agreed to hang out with me for a day and shoot a course vlog and a Be Better Golf live video. So if you have questions for Mike, go to my Instagram and just put them in the comments to the Mike Malaska posting you see there. He has some really kind of out there things separately about the swing that I think you guys are really gonna like. So lots of really cool stuff going on with the channel, but you might not see it if you don't subscribe. So hit the subscribe button. All right, see you guys later.